Someone turned this $500,000 home in Naples into a very colorful eyesore. Neighbors say this unique paint job happened over the course of a week. NBC2's Alex Howard is in our studio. Alex, I can imagine why neighbors are not too pleased.
I don't think I'd like living next to him either. A Naples Homeowners Association just got back to me. It's actually suing the man they say trashed this house. People I talked to today say they just couldn't believe someone would go this wild.
Just checking out my friend's house for him, who lives here part-time.
When Alan Clowans went to check on his friend's house here in Naples, he didn't expect this.
Can't believe it. I absolutely can't believe someone would do something like this.
In the small community of Il Regalo Circle, this nice-looking house on Zillow looks a bit different in person.
I haven't seen the inside yet, but I would think a couple hundred thousand, something like that.
With paint splattered and sprayed in multiple bright colors all over the house, trees, lawn, and even the mailbox, it almost looks like something out of a cartoon.
Obviously has a drug issue or something going on, because I've just never seen anything like this in my life.
According to the Collier County property appraiser, the man who owns this house is 40-year-old Jeffrey Liebman, who neighbors say did this over the course of a week, even going so far as to spray "Who is Omar" on the side of the van parked outside.
I'm actually looking at the car over here. I don't know what that means, but the guy wanted to take something out on the house instead of, you know, getting help.
Right now, we're told by management that Liebman is no longer living in the home, with Collier County Code Enforcement telling us they're looking into it. But in the meantime, this Technicolor house remains an eyesore.
I don't get it. I don't get it at all, why someone would go to this extreme.
And code enforcement tells us violations exist on this house, but they won't be taking action at this time. Any code enforcement would delay the court-ordered sale of that property. As for Liebman, he's due in court on February 25th on drug charges. Live in studio, Alex Howard, NBC2.